Ladies and gents, festival season has finally begun. The weather is lovely. I am drunk and late. How are you feeling?
Good.
Thumbs up.
A bit hungover.
We are now on our way to Portals Festival in East London, which is a 2-day festival, which requires us to not have to camp, which is thumbs up from me. Before getting the very, very long train, we're gonna hit up Tesco, grab some train bevvies, be general degenerates. I also need some sort of food because I haven't eaten today, and I went to the Heavy Music Awards last night and I'm still incredibly hungover.
Oh, sorry.
So let's get a meal deal and you guys can rank it. So, as per usual, we're pretty late. Festival started a couple hours ago, but the first band we're seeing today is on at 3:40. So should be okay. If the tube works.
I sure hope it does.
We have made it to the venue and it's really cool in here. We're in sunny Hackney. It's really cool. There are like three venues in here. Three. So we're gonna check them all out.
Thanks so much, Previous Taylor, for giving me more work to do in post. Earth is comprised of three venues. The theatre, originally a 1930s old-timey cinema, now a space to catch gigs, screenings, and comedy. It provides patrons with both seating and standing options, the seating we obviously made the most of. Next, we have the hall. This is Earth's main venue and the central hub of Portals Festival. Here you can buy merch, some really nice locally brewed IPAs, which I will demonstrate pouring for you now. Wow, exceptional pour. Such dexterity and skill. Never has a drink been poured so flawlessly. In the hall, we can expect to find a variety of bands over the weekend, including the headliners, Mono, and So I Watch You From Afar. And finally, we have the kitchen slash bar area. The food served here was incredible. You can also grab some merch and catch some of the smaller bands in this beautiful, neon-lit bar. The vibes up here were perfect and had a very lovely atmosphere. This place ended up being one of my favorites to visit. With that rundown complete, let's get on with the vlog.
Place is like a maze. You go in one entrance and come out completely the other side of the venue.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
What is happening? Who are these people? What are they doing?
No, there's a xylophone!
I'd now like to introduce everyone to this chap right here. This is Asher, one of the masterminds behind Portals Festival. Before attending the fest, I got the opportunity to interview Asher and ask him some questions from both myself and my community. If you'd like to see the full interview, please let me know in the comments below. So Asher, tell us a little bit about the festival.
I love it. And I'm really proud of what we've achieved as well. You know, it started from just an idea, like, let's do it. You know, we were doing all day as, can we do a two-dayer, can we do two stages, can we add a third stage, and can we build this just ourselves? And you know, it simultaneously probably added the most stress than anything else in my life, but it's also been probably the most rewarding thing I've done, because we have now built a lovely sort of little crowd of people who are really enthusiastic and really appreciate it. And
Asher is absolutely right in saying this. They really have created such a close-knit community of passionate music lovers who know how to have a good time and really enjoy the music they're seeing. Hats off to the team for this one. By far one of the most welcoming and inviting festivals I've ever attended.
My experience today has been amazing.
Back to the vlog.
Quick Portals rundown so far. The sound is brilliant. We've seen four random bands. Keep walking into a different room and there is a band playing. And every time I walk in, it's like a biblical experience. We saw an orchestra and a choir, completely by accident. And it was a very, very cool experience. A little bit difficult to film in here because it's dark. But layout of the festival, pretty cool.
Yeah, it's super nice. I love that it's got like what it, well, I think you probably saw earlier, like it's got the Seer Theatre here, which is amazing.
Yeah. We can sit down. So for tomorrow, when we see Mono, we can sit. And A.A. Williams, who is obviously one of our highlights of the weekend, if you've watched any of my videos before, we can sit down and watch her, which is...
Especially since now we're old enough to be in our
Seer gig. Yeah, I'm 24 and I want to sit down at every single show I ever go to, so I'm a fan.
Hot digging and dumb.
Best band so far?
I think Broken Islands. I think they were like the best one. The sound was a little bit crunchy, but I think overall they were good.
Human Pyramids was amazing. We saw a band called Bone Ingrin, who were like, I don't even know how to describe them. You'll see them.
Meters and meters of the most luscious hair you've ever seen.
So much hair, and it was fucking unreal. But like, I mean, you'll see in the video, but they. I can't even describe it. It was so weird, but in like a good way. I need some Gaviscon though.
Gaviscon, please sponsor us.
Gaviscon, give us a sponsorship. My heart burns for you. The Jeeves Corner's first unboxing video. I'd like to show you guys a little bit of insight. Give you guys a little bit of insight into what I'm buying some shops here. So first of all, we have the BrewDog Elvis juice, purchased solely for the fact that it's 6.5%. We've got this golden pineapple crush.
This is such a questionable choice, but I'm so intrigued.
The anchor has purchased a seltzer. I don't agree with this decision. I think White Claws are trash. However, I understand times are tough. We need to get drunk, so a seltzer.
So what, fucking rude.
What more could you want? The Gordon's Gin and Diet Tonic. I mean, how could you go wrong? Gordon clearly knew what he was up to when he created Gordon's London Dry. Who is Gordon?
Love you, long time, Gordon.
How can you go wrong with cherry wine? Not even cherry crisp cherry either. Wine. Cherry rind?
Cherry brandy.
They're warm. Why are they warm?
Clink.
It's not very good. It's not that great.
Whilst I enjoy my street beverages like the goblin I am, let's check back in with Asher and find out a little bit more about one of the upcoming performers.
I mean, you just mentioned, you know, earlier, A.A. Williams, we put on, I think, her second or third ever gig, and she opened the Dome stage in, I think it was 2018. Now, 5 years on, she's playing in a, you know, the theatre stage at Earth. Yeah. And, you know, we've seen the growth that she's made in that time.
This festival is very well organized. We are, however, going to bail because it's a very long train ride back home, but I've escaped with some merch. So much merch, in fact. So much merch! Day one, 10 out of 10, I think. Very well organized. Everyone is so very nice. Saw many, many bands. Some by accident.
I'm just going to spare you this section of the vlog. What actually happened is I woke up at a reasonable time, went for a 10k sprint, raised a small family of ducklings, planted and grew an old oak tree, and edited this vlog before I'd even finished filming it.
Good morning, party people. It's day two of Portals Festival, and day three of having activities to do. Day one of the festival was really, really sick. Super well managed and put together. Thank you so much, Asher and Sam, for being so accommodating and lovely. Sound was amazing. The venue is really easy to navigate as well. It's a super cool venue. They operate like a one-way system, so kind of once you've gone in one place, you gotta make it the whole way around, but it doesn't take too long. As I said, it's very well organized. So far, it's been a 10 out of 10 experience. I got to see a bunch of bands that I love, some random bands I'd never heard of before, like Human Pyramids. Very, very cool. I might have cried just a little bit. Just a little bit, not a lot though. Day two, we've got a bunch of bands today, obviously Mono being the highlight, the band I'm most looking forward to seeing. So currently it's like 11 a.m. I'm gonna go down and get a bottle of gin. And get to work to get a little bit buzzed before we leave and go see Pupil Slicer first. Coolest band with the most grotesque, uncomfy band name. It feels very nice that festival season has officially begun. And what a way to start it with Portals Festival, which you guys should definitely come and check out if you have the opportunity to.
Ooh, that's good.
Are you prepared for another day?
No.
No. No is the consensus. Well, we're doing it anyway. Surprisingly, not hungover, feeling relatively okay. Only mild crippling anxiety. So we're doing good. Went to the shops, bought drinks, immediately forgot my bag that has everything in it, including my Gaviscon supply. So I'm gonna miss some bands. I'm running back now. Every fucking time, man. My brain, the size of like a pea, but a small one, smaller than usual.
It was at this exact moment when disaster struck.
Another slight hiccup. The next train is in either 4 minutes or 40. So doesn't bode well. This doesn't bode well for today.
Disgusting. We're back.
I think we got a pretty good spot here.
I don't know. I'm worried I won't be able to see or hear them from here, and yet. I think I might be okay.
Just saw gold, possibly one of the best fans I've ever seen.
Absolutely.
One of the best front women I've ever seen. It was very emotional, and they sounded amazing. Honestly, 10, 11, 12 out of 10. We also have returned and grabbed the cherry bee. Look at this degenerate loitering on someone's garden wall, outer garden wall.
I'm having a hard time.
This is first you drink cans on the train, and now look at you.
Respect your fucking
elders. Now before another band. I'm a bit out of the loop now. But the food is banging, so food time. This is unreal, holy fuck. Emotions are running high right now. You can't see anything! Favorite band is about to go on stage. It's Mono.
The Mono being the highlight.
Go get like front barrier for Mono. Who I'm very excited for. I'm gonna cry. And when I saw them at ArcTangent, I cried. And I'm gonna cry here. I'm so fucking excited.
Thank you so much for taking the time to come and chat to me for a little bit. Thank you for your time. I look forward to this weekend, man. It's so close.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, for you and for your coverage and help and support as well. And look forward to having a beer with you this weekend.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's make sure it happens. All right. thank you so much, Asher. I appreciate you.
No worries. You too. Take care.
Cheers, man. Bye-bye.